My name is Kanen. Hi, my name is Kanen from Futurum Corporate Finance Advisory. You can visit my website at www.futurumcorfinan.com, or you can send email to me, futurumcorfinan@gmail.com. Okay, so I'm going to make a video about using Fed rate in forecasting the growth rate during the explicit forecast period in the DCF discounted cash flow based valuation. Okay. Right, so this is all the video about. I give you a bit background about this. I'm going to use the so in the use this is from the Aswad, Professor Aswad Damodaran Applied Corporate Finance book. So if you look at this, we have a high growth. So for example, you have a forecast period probably 5 or 10 years, and then you have a high growth, but of course you cannot maintain the high growth period to the end forever, because definitely competitor will be coming, will be trying to get a bit of your cake. So at the end of the day, your high growth period will gone unless in a certain very real situation where you are protected by copyright, you're protected by patent, you have a very strong credible brand in the market. So you should have a very something that can make the entry barrier very high for your competitor. Otherwise it will become your product become a commodity, and everybody will earn a very low, very fair or normal rate of return. So your high growth will be going down to your stable growth period. Usually this is the period before the stable growth period. This is what we call like a explicit forecast period. So at the end of the explicit forecast period, you're going to enter a very steady growth period. This is usually we have the terminal value. So we have a two-stage growth model, or usually people will build like a three high growth, and then followed by a transition. This is where it probably your patent expired, probably because of the government regulation, a negative investment list, where based on the newly issued regulation, then it's possible for the competitor to sell quite similar product like yours, like the company's product. So you're going to see there's a high growth, and then there's a transition period. Your sales growth will going down to the stable growth period. Okay. If you go to the, we can see in the industry, for example, I take from the DBS Fikas Securities research in the early 2015 in Indonesia, you can see that the multi finance growth will ultimately will be quite flat. So you can see that like consumer financing from 2008 you around 20%, and then you down, and then you up again, but you going to see is going down. I think this is like a soft landing to the September 2014 around 10%. So you can see that probably at the end of the day, the sales growth in the like this is like 7 years, it will be quite around like a 10%. Okay, so this is the same like in the. This is like what in the financial in the company, you know, company life, product life cycle or business cycle. You can see that first during the early part of the company life, the sales growth is going up, slowly and then you're going to beat faster in this area and then you're going to enter a plateau area. This is where the business is matured and then you can see if there's no innovation then it'll be going down. So this is will be followed by the earnings as well. So with the time when the comp I think the key is in the market, the industry is the industry not growing up, then definitely you can only grow your sales growth at the expense of your competitor. So basically you like stealing you from your competitor market share. But of course if this is a very dynamic market, your competitor will not be just sit comfortably or quietly. Definitely they will fight back to keep or to maintain their existing or the current market share, or even can do something more than that through the promotion, through the better service, excellent service, best in the class service that can really grab the company market share. So basically you can see that your market share instead of up is down. Okay, and then also in your return on equity, so over time with the the time you can see that like a T plus 5, so your high return on equity will be have a moving down to the level that not quite different from your competitor. So your competitor also will do the same things. So this is like a very normal situation that we see in the market. So as an analyst, when you prepare your forecast sales growth, you need to be very careful to make sure that your sales growth will be going down to the industry sales growth. Okay, I'm going to use a Fed rate to reflect that situation. Okay, I'll see you in the next video.